In this screencast, we are going to show how to solve differential equations using the Laplace transform. For this problem here, we'll use the equation that is shown with the initial conditions also provided. In order to solve this equation using Laplace transforms, we need to individually go term by term and take the Laplace transform of each of the four terms. First, we're going to look at the derivatives. And the analysis of the derivatives can be done by taking advantage of the real differentiation theorem, of which is shown right here. The real differentiation theorem shows that any derivative can be evaluated using the equation above. The first term represents the s raised to the power of the order of the derivative multiplied by the Laplace transform variable. All of the remaining terms have evaluations based on the value at time equals zero of the function and of the appropriate derivatives. Here, since y of zero and y prime of zero both equal zero, these terms can just go away because they are identically zero. With this information, we can easily take the Laplace transform of the first two terms. So the Laplace transform of the second derivative, d squared y dt squared, will be, looking at the first term, s raised to the order of the derivative, which in this case is to the second power, multiplied by the Laplace transform variable, which is capital Y for this case here. For our first derivative, we'll take the Laplace transform of 5 dy dt. According to the rules of the Laplace transform, 5 can be factored out as if it were a regular number, which would leave us with 5 times the Laplace transform of the first derivative. Therefore, this will equal 5 multiplied by the s variable raised to the appropriate power, which in this case is the first order differential, so it'll be multiplied by the first power, multiplied by Laplace transform variable y. For the third term, the Laplace transform of a variable is the Laplace transform variable. So therefore, the Laplace transform variable of 6 times y in the time domain, again, we can factor out the 6, so it's going to equal 6 times the Laplace transform of y, and that is just going to equal 6 times the Laplace transform variable represented as capital Y. Finally, x of t is provided as a step change of magnitude 2. By looking at a Laplace transform sheet, you'd be able to find the fact that the Laplace transform of a step of 2 will just be 1 over s, which is the Laplace for a step function, multiplied by the constant 2. So therefore, this will just become 2 over s. With each term being converted into the Laplace domain, we can now develop our equation to be solved in the Laplace domain. So our equation now becomes s squared y plus 5sy plus 6y equals 2 over s. Our goal here is to solve for y. So therefore, what we're going to now do is group together the y terms, leaving us with y times s squared plus 5s plus 6 equals 2s. And if we were to solve that for y, that would leave us with y equals 2 over s times s squared plus 5s plus 6. The next step to solve this equation in the Laplace domain is we have to break the system down into the roots of the equation, because we need to be able to use a Laplace transform table to take the inverse Laplace transforms. And there really aren't any Laplace transforms that correspond to s squared plus 5s plus 6. However, if we look at this, we can see the fact that s squared plus 5s plus 6 can easily be factored into s plus 2 multiplied by s plus 3. If we look at our Laplace transform, we do have something for a over s plus 2 and b over s plus 3, where a and b are constants. So what we now need to do is find those constants. So in order to do that, we have to use the method of partial fractions. So the next step is to use partial fractions. And to use partial fractions, we have to break our function up, which we've already done by separating the roots. So y will equal 2 over s times s squared plus 5s plus 6, which is going to equal a over s plus b over s plus 2 plus c over s plus 3. Our goal now is to find all of the values of A, B, and C that will allow us to use the Laplace transform table to take the inverse Laplace transforms. In order to do that, we have to find the least common denominator for each of these functions. So what we're going to now do is focus solely on the numerator. So the numerator of y is going to equal 2. And that's also going to equal, when we factor out, a times s plus 2 times s plus 3 plus b times s plus 3 plus c times s times s plus 2. We now factor out the a, b, and c terms that we've developed here, remembering the fact that it still has to equal 2. So this is going to equal as squared plus 5as plus 6a plus bs squared plus 3bs plus, for the c terms, we have cs squared plus 2cs. And as a reminder, based on what our numerator was from the beginning, all of this has to equal 2. So here we have s squared terms, s terms, and s to the 0 terms, in other words, the constants. What we can do to more easily solve this is develop a table separating out the s squareds from the s's from the constants. That table can be shown below. By looking at this table, we can easily use the s to the 0 terms to solve for a. So we have the fact that 6a equals 2, which means the fact that a will equal 1/3. So what now we're left with is we have the s squared and s equations that we have to solve simultaneously. Our s squared equation is a plus b plus c, which will be here 1/3 plus b plus c equals 0, which can be rewritten as b plus c equals negative 1/3. For our s term, we have 5 times 1/3 plus 3b plus 2c equals 0. And when we rearrange that, that leaves us with 3b plus 2c equals negative 5/3. Again, remember here the fact that it's negative because the 5/3 term is moving to the other side of the equation. Now, we can solve for both b and c using any one of a number of different algebraic methods. Here, we will multiply the first equation, the s squared term, by negative 2. So what we now have is negative 2b minus 2c equals negative 1/3 times negative 2 is 2/3. And then we have just our same equation we had before for the s term, 3b plus 2c equals negative 5/3. Now we add these together, the 2c terms will cancel out, which will leave us with b equals negative 1. To find c, we just substitute it into any of the equations we've developed. So we know the fact that b plus c equals negative 1/3. So negative 1 plus c equals negative 1/3, which means the fact that c will equal positive 2/3. Now we can substitute a, b, and c into the original equation. Recall that our equation that we started with was y equals a over s plus b over s plus 2 plus c over s plus 3. We have just found the fact that our constants are a equals 1/3, b equals negative 1, and c equals 2/3. Therefore, our equation now becomes y equals 1/3 over s minus 1 over s plus 2 plus 2/3 over s plus 3. We can now take the inverse Laplace transform of each of these terms. The first one is 1/3 over s, and if we look at a Laplace transform table, the inverse Laplace transform of 1 over s is just a constant itself. We have the 1/3 as a factor, so therefore that holds true. And what we're left with for this first term is the inverse Laplace transform is just 1/3. To look at the Laplace transform of 1 over s plus 2, this is often represented in Laplace transform as 1 over s plus a or s plus b or some constant. If you go to the other side of the Laplace transform to take the inverse Laplace transform of this, that will just be an exponential raised to the negative 2t. The 1 over s plus a Laplace transform is just as valid for the third and final term except instead of it being e to the negative 2t, it'll be e to the negative 3t. The 2/3 constant comes out, and that leaves us with 2/3 e to the negative 3t. What we'll now do is put back in the signs. We get a plus sign in between the second and third term, and a negative sign in between the first and second term. And we've taken the inverse Laplace transform of the right-hand side, so we have to do the same thing for the left-hand side. And the inverse Laplace transform of a variable is itself in the time domain. So what we're left with now is little y of t equals 1/3 minus e to the negative 2t plus 2/3 multiplied by e to the negative 3t, which is the solution to our differential equation.